Hi, I'm Malia Albrecht from the Google News Initiative, and today we'll walk through how to estimate the amount of money your news organization can earn from reader subscriptions or donations. In the past 15 years, one of the biggest trends in the news industry has been the rise of digital subscriptions. Take a look at this graph of revenue from the New York Times. You see that orange section that gets larger year after year? That's their digital subscription revenue, which is now worth more than $800 million annually, more than any other source. So you might be wondering, how much money could a subscription earn from my news organization? At the Google News Initiative, I lead our labs, which are training and coaching programs for news organizations on topics like launching a subscription, increasing your advertising revenue, and analyzing your audience's behavior. To get started, you can apply for our Fundamentals Lab in countries around the world at g.co/newsinitiative/labs. But in this short video, we will walk you through a Google tool to help you estimate how much you could earn through subscriptions or donations. It's called the Reader Revenue Calculator, and you can find it on our website. Feel free to open it up in another window while you watch. Let's start with the basics. What do you need to calculate reader revenue? Reader revenue depends on a few factors. 1. How large your audience is. 2. How many of them might become subscribers or donors. 3. How much money each person will pay or donate. And lastly, how many people will cancel their subscription or recurring donation. So how are these four things measured? First, for how large your audience is, you'll need your monthly active users and an average growth rate. For expected subscribers or donors, you'll need your annual conversion rate. Next, for how much money each person will pay or donate, we'll use average revenue per user, also known as ARPU. Lastly, for cancellations, you'll need churn rate, which measures how many people unsubscribe every year. But how important are each of these metrics when it comes to revenue? What impact does each of them have? And could improving just one metric make a big difference? These metrics will all vary over time, sometimes due to reasons outside of your control. But setting clear goals for metrics that matter, explaining how your goals help you meet revenue targets, and creating an action plan with your team can help everyone stay focused. We designed this tool to help you do just that, so let's walk through how it works. First, you'll answer a few questions about your model, like whether you have a subscription or collect donations. Just so you know, Google doesn't store any of your answers or data that you input here. Next, you'll enter the metrics we just talked about. If you're not sure about any of these metrics, or if you haven't launched your subscription or donations page yet, feel free to use the suggested industry averages. All right, let's get started. First, enter your monthly active users from the last 30 days. If you're just starting out, take your target audience size, like your local population or households, and estimate what percentage you think you could reach. Then, you'll need a growth rate. You can calculate that by taking your current monthly active users and dividing that number by the monthly active users from the previous month, and then subtracting 1. Typically, 3% is the industry average. Next, conversion rate, which is how many people subscribe compared to your audience size. Generally, we find that most publishers calculate this rate annually. So for example, if 2,000 people subscribed last year and you have 100,000 monthly active users, your conversion rate is 2%. Keep in mind, industry averages range depending on population size. In places with over 1 million people, conversion rates are about 2%, while smaller places with less than 1 million people average about 4%. Okay. So now let's look at your average reader revenue per user, or ARPU, which measures how much money you earn from every subscriber or donor every month. Most news organizations have different subscription offerings at different prices, so ARPU is a quick estimation. As a general rule, you can take your total subscription revenue and divide that by your total subscribers. For example, if you earn $50,000 each month and have 5,000 subscribers, your average revenue per user would be $10. As a benchmark, that's the average revenue per user for places with less than 1 million people. In bigger places, that average goes up to $15. Finally, your churn rate measures how many people unsubscribe each month. Across the industry, churn rates are about 3 to 5%, according to FDI Consulting, Mather Economics, and FT Strategies. By one estimate, attracting a new subscriber can cost 5 times more than keeping an existing one. And increasing retention by just 5% can increase your profits anywhere from 25 to 95%. That means you'll make more money over time by focusing on churn rate. With almost 10% of subscribers canceling in the first 24 hours, it's important to focus on actions to keep those people. Great, Now we're done. Click See Results to get your estimate. You can adjust your metrics and see how those changes impact your revenue and subscribers. The bar on the left shows your estimate based on what you entered first, and the bar on the right shows what your new revenue would be. If you need to change your original entries, simply click Edit. You can also compare against the industry averages we mentioned. They appear on the metrics as red lines. When you're done playing with the tool, you can click Download and share this data with someone you work with and use it to create a plan on how to improve these metrics. For example, let's say you want to focus on conversion rate, average revenue per user, or churn rate. What are some examples of things you can do? For increasing your conversion rate, I'll share three best practices, and you can also check our lesson for more. First, increase awareness of your subscription on your site. Second, offer three options to make decisions easy and highlight your best one. Third, add cancel anytime to your subscription page, which has been proven to boost conversion rates. You can also watch the lesson on checkout. For average revenue per user, here are a few best practices we recommend. First, offer different price points. It'll be easier for people to choose if you follow the three options best practice. Second, promote your annual option, such as offering a discount. Annual subscribers are 65% more likely to subscribe in year two compared to monthly subscribers. Lastly, offer different prices based on engagement, such as offering a promotion to less engaged readers. And finally, here are some best practices to reduce your churn rate. First, email article recommendations to subscribers who haven't logged in recently. Second, celebrate their milestones, like sending an email on their birthday or first year anniversary. Third, send a 3-email campaign to new subscribers, such as a welcome from the editor, newsletter offerings, and more. Once you set your revenue goals and know how each metric plays a role, you can create a plan to get there. That's all for this video. But if you're interested in other ways to grow your reader revenue, please check out our other lessons and send any questions you might have to contactgni@google.com. The Google News Initiative provides in-depth coaching for news organizations with industry experts through our labs. You can learn more and apply on our website at g.co/newsinitiative/labs. Thank you, and best of luck on your reader revenue journey.